I honestly didn't know what Sundance was when I was young and first starting to think about filmmaking. I became aware of Sundance probably in undergrad when I went to the Cannes Film Festival in 2010 through the Creative Minds in Cannes program, actually. And that was probably the first time I realized that film festivals can really launch your career and launch your project. I was in the filmmaker track, so I was making a short film there and really just got a chance to experience my first film festival. But even though it was on a small level, in a lot of ways, it kind of prepared me for having a feature film at Sundance.
Started this project, it was us three at USC, capable with this idea and us saying, let's do it.
This is our first feature film as a producer, as a director. For that film to get into Sundance and come from so far when we were in school together, it's a surreal experience to get to the biggest film festival in the country and have a premiere here.
We're here obviously to sell the film, but that's not the most important thing. The most important thing is, like, we all made this as a family and we want those people by our side to be successful with us.
Growing up in Cleveland, I was like, yo, I haven't seen anything out of my hometown. Like, I want to just put that on film. It's overwhelming, man. To finally have our film here at Sundance, you know, it's like, I keep telling people it's surreal.
I wouldn't be here if I hadn't grown up the way I did on a farm in South Carolina, working with my granddad on his produce stand, selling peaches, like straight up country. Being around grassroots entrepreneurship is what gave me the scrappiness that I have that allows me to produce. Having the scrappiness and kind of the ingenuity to know how to make something out of nothing. You plant a seed in the ground, you water it until there's a plant, and then that plant bears fruit or vegetables. It's the same exact thing with film. We've been planting seeds for 2.5 years for this project, and it's not until now that we're finally starting to bear some fruit.
I'm not preachy, you know, when I'm telling my films. So I try to, like, in a subtle way, let you know what this movie's about, but I want you to walk out knowing that you fell in love with some kids. That was the goal at hand. You're about to watch this movie, and I introduce them as criminals and thugs for a reason, so that way by the end of the movie, you see that they're actual kids. Nas, I met before we started shooting. And I sat down with Nas, and we just connected. The vibe and energy was there. He was digging my short films. We left on a note, like, you know, anything you need, just hit me up. Nas makes sense for a film like this because of the rap music, because how conscious he is and thoughtful, how much he gives to the streets, how much he talks about the streets from every album, from Illmatic till on. And so I was like, let me ask him. And literally they were like, it's as good as done. He had a few titles. He had executive producer title and he had music EP. He was really active, man. He was hands-on. It was a beautiful thing and a crazy experience. Erykah Badu came on as an actress. She read the script, responded, chopped it up about the character, and she really was in tune and she committed. Sheen Gunn Kelly was one of the first people on the project. So we met in Cleveland. He was super cool and was like, I'm down. Like, I'm down to be in this movie, whatever you need, anything with the city. And he was like, and I'm down to do some music. Like, whatever we want to do. He came in, he acted, and as well as he did music for the film. But all in all, man, like, you just can't stop the nerves. So your stomach is like, I hope people like this film. We have the actors flying in and they're doing press. And meanwhile, we're prepping for a concert, prepping to get Nas, Erykah Badu on stage, Machine Gun Kelly. And I was nervous as crap the entire way, but as I kept seeing the familiar faces, like, we're a family, it was just dope. Like, to see Nas coming, like, let's do this, baby. And Erykah's like, I'm ready. And everyone's like, yo, this is like magic. Like, it's family here in the room, and we're all showing each other love and excited to be at Sundance.
The sale is important, obviously, because it helps us all jump off from here. I mean, you're experiencing it and you're having a good time, but you're here to work. This is a business conference for us in a lot of ways. We're all here to move up and to move on to the next and to get another project going.
I want to develop a project that makes sense for people to come to the theater and see. They want to come and hear a message, see a message, feel something, and leave the theater different than they came out.
When you're up there with your actors and your team, you just kind of want to see them ride out. Seeing the smile of the faces of the producers and the crew and the audience is being like, this is what we were working for. Like, this is cool. It's an amazing experience.
35 days absent.
What are you doing with your time?
You are finishing your trade.
To be a mechanic.
Better than being a bum. You have to do something with your life. What are you good at?
Who is that?
Oh, this is Molly.
Yo, you crazy?
We could sell these.
Can even help our families.
You try and explain to your family how you're working for free for years and years and years. Nobody gets it. Nobody understands it. And then to have them come and sit in the audience next to you and experience it with you, and they finally understand. And you get to see the pride in their eyes and the joy in their eyes of seeing like their sons do something that they've just dreamed of forever.
Free from scars, free to sing, free from bars, free my dogs, you're free to go.